There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. We're racing in the Rhine Valley this weekend, the home of many of the sport's finest competitors. The 2.8-mile Hockenheim Ring requires precision through the technical stadium section and great raw speed down the long, flat-out curve towards the popular overtaking zone at the Turn 6 hairpin. Watch out for a lot of wheel-to-wheel action there today. And it's an absolute pleasure to be joined once again by Anthony Davidson. They've got a really good lead in the championship going into this weekend, so it feels to me that they've got one hand on the trophy.
Let's not get too ahead of ourselves, Crofty. Yes, it looks like a big lead, but all it takes is a locked brake into turn one, a sticky wheel nut in the pit stop, and that could all get turned on its head. You can never discount one more sting in the tail.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. It's McLaren in pole position then, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Bottas, Weber, Charles Leclerc and Hülkenberg, Perez, Stroll, Sainz and Pierre Gasly, Norris, Magnussen, Daniel Ricciardo and Butler, Kvyat, Albon, Lewis Hamilton and George Russell, Kubica and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care. Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. a decent start. Good job. There's 16 laps of fuel remaining. This lap for the race. You're putting a good distance between yourself and the car behind. this lap of the race. Keep this up. Pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Complete, go now. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. We have 10 laps of fuel remaining. Is in for his stop.
Thank you.
fastest lap of the race so far. Some information on Magnussen, they're retiring from the race. VSC deployed, the virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending, wait for green. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. turbocharger is on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. This is your final lap of the race. Less than a lap of fuel now, the tank is empty. Fantastic drive, just fantastic. You deserve that race win.
It was a tough race at times, but they've held on to take a great victory for McLaren today. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance.